Good afternoon. My name is Subuga Ramadan, a teacher of business, Light Academy. And the interest of today's lesson, I think it will serve two classes at the same time. That is Senior 4 and Senior 3. Within the commerce topics, I've decided to choose a business calculation as a topic, and within the introduction, we know very well that in our senior 1, senior 2 work, we looked at the definition of a business, and we say that a business, I'm repeating, a business is any activity carried out with a motive of making profits within a given period or losses. Of course, those profits are likely to be made by individuals or a firm that has decided to take on a given business. The profits or losses made can only be got after calculations are done at the end of a given period. Let's come to agree. Whatever we have in life, there is time period for it. For example, I'm a teacher of commerce within Light Academy, but there is a period for which I'm serving, and there will be a period for which I'll stop actually serving. This simply means that for even a business that has been started, you find that it has a period for which it has to run. Down as we continue, I'll talk about types of businesses. Of course, that's a review as well. I'm sure we've already covered those at our levels of senior 1 and senior 2. But for the interest of actually getting the required knowledge, there's no problem if we review that. Now, if it is true that any business that actually runs, the aim and objective is to make profits, it's a requirement that the owner or individual or the firm takes trouble to calculate the profits that have been made within a given period. I just want us, maybe before we go further, to come to know the importances of business calculation. Why do you think, why do we have to study business calculation? One of the reasons I've already written here is to calculate the profits or losses that are made within a given period. Number two, to know the assets and liabilities of a business or an individual within a given trading period. I want us to put into consideration the other term that I talked about, time frame. These profits are normally calculated within a month, that is given the nature of business that we are talking about at a given time. On the other hand, given the type of the business, it can also be calculated within a year. Within this line, I just want us to go back to the level of senior 2, maybe senior 1, some of the types of businesses that some of us would like or have studied about in class. Types of businesses that we have. If we were in a classroom environment, I would actually be posing a question. Can you people list for me the types of businesses that we've looked at, for which some can apply the business calculation that we are talking about? Some of these businesses that we are talking about, number one, we have the sole proprietorship business. That's a business that is run or managed or controlled by an individual. We have the partnership business. We have the joint stock companies. We have businesses that are managed or owned or controlled by a government, and there are many others. Under sole proprietorship, in senior 1, we looked at maybe small-scale businesses under which we listed many. Now, given all the list that I've talked about in terms of types of businesses. It is in the interest of all those types of businesses that business cultivation is done within a given period, so that we can easily know whether a given business has made profits or losses. We should know also that any business to be started, the motive behind it is to make profits or losses. Now, given this introduction, I just want us to go to the slides, and then we actually deal with some of the definitions that we might be having under business cultivation that can lead us to further cultivation of businesses, of numbers that we might be having under this one. That's business cultivation. Before we go to that, just like any other topic under commerce, I'm talking about terms under business cultivation. But remember, when we are talking about insurance, there were terms that we looked at under insurance. For example, you looked at terms like insurance, subrogation, maybe under principles. You looked at insurers, you looked at insured, among others. Under money and banking, it's also a topic where we have terms in any topic under commerce. You find that there are terms that we need to look at that actually give us an introduction of where we are heading. And I would like to take this opportunity to actually go through the slides that I have prepared, and they are clearly explaining the terms that we have to use under business cultivation. Now, a business, we say it, is any activity carried out with an aim of making profits while standing a chance or risk of making losses. As we had in the introduction, we had a list of types of businesses, among which we listed, for example, sole trade, partnership, joint stock companies, cooperatives, marketing boards, and there are others that you can easily think about in case those that are owned by the government. Now, that list of businesses, you find that none of them can easily run without calculating profits or losses at the end of a given trading period. It is for that reason that within our commerce that we start at this level, we need to know how these businesses can easily carry out this calculation, can easily ascertain the profits or losses that are made within a given period. Now, as a continuation under business calculation, these are some of the additions that we might be having. For example, the unfortunate businessman who gets risks suffers losses instead of making and enjoying profits. This is obvious. The motive behind somebody starting a business is profit making. But in case he's unfortunate, or in case of the risks that you cannot easily think about, you find that losses are inevitable. Right now, the period in which we are like not running normal businesses. Why? Because of the COVID-19 problem that we are suffering worldwide. You'll find that there are many businesses that are encountering losses. And these are the risks that we are talking about. Of course, there are other risks that we might be having on board. Now, it is therefore important that business cultivation should be made by business owners so that they check their financial stand from time to time. That one is expected, and it is aimed at ascertaining, in other words, knowing the profits or knowing whether the business has made profits or losses. That's within a given period. By the way, to confirm about the period that we talk about, normally, given the nature of business, if it is a small-scale business, for example, sole proprietorship, they normally choose to maybe go into business calculation, to carry out business calculation in terms of record keeping just within a period of 6 months. That's given the nature of business. For those businesses that are run on large scale, normally they require a short period in order to carry out a business calculation. And which period would that be? That one does not go beyond a month. Give reason, it is a business run on large scale. They have so many books within their offices, and it is a requirement in terms of auditing their books. And from that, I feel, as I said in the first presentation, there are terms that have to be used under business calculations. Let us remember that for every topic, as I said, under business, under commerce, each topic, for example, money and banking, I said, there are new terms that we have listed and we need to simplify them. Under insurance, there are also terms that we normally study. And for example, under insurance, we can look at terms like insurance itself, what's insurance, number two, insurer, insured, subrogation as a principle. There are many others. Now, when it comes to business calculation, there are also terms that we're interested in, among which we have the following. We have the income statement. As it is written here, this is at times referred to as a trading profit and loss account. Just mark these two terms, trading profit and loss accounts. Now, within the income statement, if anyone is keeping records, you'll find that the income statement is composed of the trading profit and loss account. As we continue, you'll find that the trading account is used to determine the profit, or is used to determine the gross profit or gross loss of the business within a given trading period. And the profit and loss account is used to ascertain or to determine the net profit or net loss of the business within a given trading period. You'll find that this, as number one, there is a lot that we are going to look at that is supposed to be listed under the income statement. For example, there are many. We can have the opening stock, we can have the purchases, we can have the net purchases. There are many others, as we shall see. Now, after this one, it's a continuation, and I think this is what I was talking about. The trading profit and loss account, and the purpose for which they have to be prepared is clearly shown here. The trading account is used to determine the gross profit and gross loss of a business within a given trading period. That one, we have to add it, much as it is not highlighted there. Now, the profit and loss account, profit and loss account is used to determine the net profit and net loss of the business within a given trading period. Of course, this net profit and net loss can only be calculated, of course, if you have considered the expenses that have been incurred by business within that quoted period. Please. Okay, that is the trading account. We have a term two, which is opening stock. The word opening simply means something, at least, that should be starting for the first time, we can assume. And for business purpose, you find that once one talks about stock, it is very clear that somebody is talking about tangible items that a business might be having in stock, or that a business might be having that is ready to be sold to the clients. And we are saying that this refers to the items or goods which a business starts with at the beginning of the new trading period. We said business calculation is carried out periodically, after month, after half a year, after a year. Now, at the end of a given trading period, if a new trading period is starting, We shall have goods that have been purchased and ready to be sold. Now, those items or goods, the new stock ready to be sold, is what we refer to as opening stock. And it is actually the opening stock that we get, and we add that net profit in order to get what we call the goods available for sale, as we shall see in time to come. For a starting business, opening stock depends entirely on goods bought from producers or wholesalers. Here we are just trying to quote where maybe any business can easily get the goods from, possibly wholesalers or producers. Number three, closing stock. As we looked at opening stock, this is closing stock. Once you see closing, that simply means that maybe it is at the end before you look at the definition. Once there is closing stock, that means that these are goods that a business stays with at the end of a given trading period. And at a certain point, we are going to see if these are goods that remain unsold at the end of a given trading period, we are going to look at what we call a balance sheet. And within that balance sheet, that's where we are going to record this one, closing stock, as an item. In other words, closing stock as a term directly can be listed under a balance sheet. Maybe as early as this, somebody might be asking, what's a balance sheet? To give an introduction before we get there, a balance sheet is a document that shows assets and liabilities within a given trading period. Now, this balance sheet, you clearly see that once you have closing stock listed under a balance sheet, it simply means that closing stock is an asset, but a current asset. Somebody might also be asking, what's an asset? An asset is an item of value that a business might be having within a given period. Item of value that a business might be having. So, once you have closing stock, it is an asset, it is an item of value that a business has for a given period. Number four, we have stock taking. Stock taking. This is an act of making a list of goods possessed by the business during this time. Trading activities are stopped and each item is physically counted and recorded on a stock sheet. In other words, this one is always carried out at the end of the month. Be assured, stock taking. In the interest of doing this, to know the amount of goods that are still in stock, maybe what the business can easily base on to get new purchases. Now, this is stock taking. The actual counting of goods that remain in business at the end of the month. It is physical counting. Maybe after stock taking, it's going to be stock valuation. After listing down the goods or the items that have not been actually sold within the stock sheet, there is a requirement of attaching value to them, because it's also a requirement to know the number of goods that are still in the business and the cost that is the cost of such items. So this is the act of calculating the value of all goods held in the business, of course, at the end of the month. We have number six as another term, which is purchases. It is so common a term that is used within our environment, but you realize that if we look at it widely, it is a term that normally serves under business, but normally in our classes, for example, somebody is going at the canteen, he says that I'm going to purchase a pen, but that pen or pencil that is being purchased is not for resale. In quotes, anything purchased, there is that additional phrase, it has to be sold. So, for purchases, we normally say, these are items that a business buys, but the interest for buying them is for reselling. For example, we can talk about any retail business, wholesale business, purchasing items from either wholesaler or a producer. The purpose for purchasing is for resale. So that is the purchases. We are saying that these are goods bought for resale in the business during the year. The business will continue buying more goods for resale all the year around at the end of the year. These goods are valued at their cost price to get purchases. We have the courage in words, as the word is in words. This refers to the transport charge or charges for the goods purchased, underlying the word purchased, meaning that these are goods that a business buys from a producer, a wholesaler, and for example, it's a retail business, it is the one stocking them. So the interest here is to know if they are carried inwards. After goods have been purchased, sometimes you find that the seller or the wholesaler or the producer transports the goods on behalf of the retailer, or the contribution comes from the two sides, i.e. the wholesaler makes a contribution and even the retailer can also. Now, the interest is, once a retailer, for example, goes to a producer or a wholesaler to buy the goods, that transport charge incurred in the process of transporting those purchased goods to the business, that's what we refer to as carriage inwards. And it is clearly actually written here. Carriage inwards are part of the cost of buying goods, and therefore are added to the value of purchases. In other words, once you get your net purchases, you need to add there the carriage inwards to actually get the total amount spent in the process of purchasing the goods. After this one, carriage inwards, we go to the carriage outwards. Now, for carriage outwards, after a retailer, for example, has stocked the goods, he has to sell them to any customer. We are sure, that one there is no doubt, that a customer has to, transport the goods that he has bought from the retailer to his either home state or any other point where he's going to actually have them used. So in this case, as a retailer sells the goods, it's clear that he has to transport the goods to maybe his premises. So this transport cost incurred by the buyer to transport the bought goods from a retailer, it is what we refer to as carriage inwards. In summary, this refers to the transport charges for the goods sold from the business. It is the business selling to the customers. It means the carriage charges leaving business to the customers, and it is treated as an expense. And this expense on the income statement is what we are likely to be considering also to come up with net purchases, net profit or net loss, as we are likely to see in time to come. Maybe for my summary, I just want us to go through this. It is the packet that I had for this session or presentation. Our topic has been business calculation, and within that business calculation, I say that it's a topic that is a must for any business to actually carry out calculation at the end of a given period, for which if that business is interested in ascertaining whether profits are made or losses. And as we summarize, these are the terms that I've or that we've just actually been discussing, under which we have business, we have the income statement, under which the income statement is made up of two major terms, i.e. the trading profit and loss account, for which we say that the trading account is used to ascertain the gross profit or gross loss of the business, and then the trading account is used to ascertain or to find the net profit or net loss of a business. Opening stock, these are books that any business starts with at the beginning of a new trading period. Closing stock, items or goods that remain unsold at the end of a given trading period. And we say that this one is an asset, current asset, and it is recorded under a balance sheet. As it is, please, it's not the same with this one. Looked at stock taking, that is the physical counting of goods that are within a business within a given period. And then we said that this stock taking, the items that have been, you know, physically counted are listed on the stock sheet. Stock valuation, after this one, there is attachment of value. Maybe item X is of this amount, item Y is of this amount. Purchases, these are goods that are bought for the purpose of resale. Carried inwards, these are transport charges for goods purchased, and the carriage outwards, these are transport charges for goods that are sold by business. Of course, I'm putting dashes simply because this list is still continuing. It is in my interest, and also it should be in your interest as students. Everyone should at least practice keeping records. That one is a requirement. If one is to make any good person in terms of business practice, we can start with this highlighted point, pocket money that is given. On a daily basis, that pocket money given, we can show that we keep records for that, such that at the end of maybe a day, you know how much money you spend. Given on a daily basis, that is, record keeping can be done on a daily basis. And at the end of the week, maybe, you can easily know the total amount that you spent. I'm sure if you do this at the level of an individual, it clearly gives you a clear imagination of what we are likely to look at under business graduation. It's the easiest topic that one can easily get marks from. This one is a must. Business graduation, it is known. For every paper that we do at the end of senior 4, this number is number 24. Whoever does it, in case he has got good knowledge about it, it is easier to score good marks than maybe attempting numbers within home trade. So, continuous practice is better. And then, please, this one is a caution. Please keep at home because we want you safe. COVID-19 is real. Thank you for your time. I wish to stop here and then we shall start from this point next time. Thank you.